Winchester. What a city. At one time, the Anglo-Saxon capital of this country and home to a number of Norman kings, Alfred the Great, William the Conqueror, to name but a few. And apparently, it is reported that King Arthur had his seat of power from here. And incidentally, his round table is in the Great Hall. Now, we're at the top of the city, and I'm not here to sightsee, although I quite like to. I'm here to do the South Downs Way Walk, and that's 100 miles from Winchester over to Eastbourne. Now, on YouTube, there are a number of videos that give you that blow-by-blow, step-by-step instruction of how to do this, and I'm not quite sure that this video is going to follow the same vein. I haven't decided yet. But I suppose, just like my coast-to-coast video, and if you're interested in that, I'll bang it up and you can have a look at that. I think I'm going to document this as I see it. And now, there are a number of different starts to this walk, and you can either start in the cathedral grounds or down by the city mill, and I've done both, so I've got 22 miles to do today. Yeah, the South Downs Way Walk, 100 miles, giving myself a number of days to do it. Just get it done. Miles in, and I'm currently sat on Old Winchester Hill, just having a bit of a break. Made some really good time from Winchester, considering that I left quite late, and that was because I wanted to see King Arthur's table, and the Great Hall didn't open till 10 o'clock. Now, the actual South Downs Way path runs around this hill, and the reason why I'm actually on the hill is because behind me there are some ancient burial mounds which I wanted to go and see, and you can't get access to them if you stick to the original path. So I'm gonna have a quick look at these and then get myself off to the campsite. Now, I did say that I was gonna do 22 miles today, but in actual fact, the campsite that I'm staying at is only another 3 miles away. So another hour and a bit on foot. So 18 to 19 miles today. Not too bad. Thank you. one of my South Downs Way walk over in Dunwood, and as you can hear, it's tipping down with rain outside. That last section was more like 4.5 miles, so 19.5-20 miles, give or take. The route thus far hasn't been as savage as what I experienced last year on the coastal coast. But the pathways are quite hard, so the soles of the feet take an absolute hammering. So bear that in mind if you're going to do this. And also the hills, whilst they may not be as high, they do have a steady climb, and those climbs go on for absolutely ages. So again, be warned. But in relation to the actual route itself, hats off to the creators. It's superbly signposted, almost to the point where you possibly don't even need your A to Z or your maps, but I probably jinxed it now. But what I'm going to do now is wait for the weather to die down, dry myself off, get some food, and then get to bed. This centre, it looks really, really interesting, but clearly I'm not going to go and have an explore right now, so hopefully in the morning, if it's all drier, I'll have a look around. But for now, let's get that kettle on. Day two. Sees me walking to Cocking. It's about 16 miles or so. It's still raining, and rain consistently all night, so who knows what it's going to be like outside. In relation to views and what have you, this is supposed to be quite a scenic part of the route, but clearly I don't think obviously much. It may just be a head down type of affair. I'm going to be walking wet today, so I'm going to put all my wet stuff back on. It's going to be pretty uncomfortable, I would suggest, for the first hour or so, but I'm sure I will dry out and warm up as the day goes on. Made it to Manor Farm. This particular part of the route, the ground is really, really hard on the soles of the feet. It's not a massively technical route, but lots of ups and downs, and those ups, well, they go on forever, as I said yesterday. I'm at Manor Farm. I'm in the campsite, part of the farmland. Nice level piece of ground, really inviting. Got some portaloos, and most importantly, just over there, a shower that I'm going to get into and wash the grime of the day off. £10 a pitch here, so it's really, really reasonable. And Pauline, the proprietor, really, really helpful. So if you are going to do the South Downs Way, it might be worth popping in here and give her a chuck, business-wise. But now the rain, I think, is going to come in again. I've got a bit of a break, so I'm going to set up, and then it's eat, sleep, and repeat. Day three, cocking to Amberley first, and then over to Washington. About 20-odd miles. I'm up a little bit earlier this morning. My intention is to have a little bit more of a stroll, because the last 2 days, I think, I've been doing a bit of a march rather than a stroll. And I want to take it in. So, let's see what the day brings. But first, I'm going to have a cup of coffee. Turning out to be a rainy, miserable, drizzly type of day. Until I got to this point here, I'm only nearly halfway. Well, I was going to pop into Amberley and have a brew and whatnot, but I might as well just keep cracking on. It's another 10 or so miles to Washington, and I'll see how far I get. It might be a bit closer than I thought. Washington. Well, today has been predominantly rain, but it doesn't matter, I'm here now. And the route has a couple of rises, as you'd expect, but once you get the height, it's really, really flat. And I would suggest that in the dry, you can make some real good ground. But in the wet, just a word of warning, the track is made up of cobbles and boulders and pebbles, and some of it is old Roman road. So when it's wet, it becomes very, very slippery. And just like the last 5 miles into Washington, you're actually walking on a chalk track. And when it's raining, it becomes, well, sludge and slime. This part of the walk is supposed to have some really, really good views of the south coast and the sea. But unfortunately, due to the rain and mist, that was never going to happen today. But I'm in the Washington Park campsite. I've just had a shower, and let me tell you, it was long overdue. Yesterday was a cold outdoor shower, and I don't count that. But here, I could have pitched up in there. Speaking of which, tent's all pitched up. I'm gonna have some snap, and the same as yesterday. So I'll see you tomorrow.
Day four,
and the rain gods are not letting up at all. But it doesn't matter. I've got to get myself out there at some stage. Today, my intention is to go through the village of Pycombe and down towards Kingston near Lewes, 20 or so miles. I'm just drying out my bits and bobs from the camp. I'll sort my feet out, have my coffee, and then let's hit the road. Sun is out and I've got a spring in my step, and when it's not raining the South Downs Way offers up some magnificent views. I've got the sea right in front of me, and that's where I'm heading. South Downs Way, more like South Pours Down all day. It's been absolutely torrential today. It's been hard going, a bit of a long day for me. I'm at the campsite now. I'm at Housedean Farm, and I decided that I didn't want to spend a fortnight pitching up in the rain, so I've treated myself to a camping pod. Now clearly it's a little bit more expensive than a pitch, and I'll put the pitch price up, and also the price I paid for this pod. Extravagant, yeah. Needed, absolutely. Now I can dry all my gear off and set myself up for the penultimate leg tomorrow. No one said that long distance walking needed to be uncomfortable. Day five. Now I could actually finish this walk today. By my calculations, I've got 25 miles to do. But I'm not going to do that. I'm going to break it up. So today I'm going to go to Alfriston, and that's about 14 miles away. It should be an easier stroll. After yesterday's 22 miles, my ankles, I've got to say, aren't particularly friendly this morning when I got up. But they've warmed up now. As you can see, the sun's out. And the weather forecast says it's going to be a sunny day for the majority of the day. So, got the pins out and the arms, and I'll be hitting the road soon. Just got to pack all this stuff up, have my breakfast and my coffee, and hit the road. the ups and downs of the South Downs way. It's not just the hills, I'm talking about the weather. Today, spectacular walking around in all this epicness. Now I see what the South Downs way is all about. Currently standing on 0 degrees longitude, the prime meridian, which separates the eastern hemisphere, which is where I'm going, from the western hemisphere, which is where I just come from. Now you can go and see the land where time began for modern day civilization down in Greenwich, but it's just nice to see it commemorated somewhere else. Currently in the village of Southies, made some really good time this morning. So that's 7 miles down, 7 miles to go. Today made some good time. I'm now sat at the Alfredson campsite. Really nice place here, large open grounds, not much in the way of phone reception, and the only bugbear is that the toilet block and the shower block are on both ends of the campsite, so you've got to decide which one's more important to you. Only cost £11 a pitch, so it's really reasonable. Tomorrow, last big push over to Eastbourne. 11 miles to do, so just going to continue setting up and relax for the rest of the day, and I'll see you in the morning. Day 6, Alfriston to Eastbourne, 10¾ miles, call it 11 for good measure. The weather, well, it was raining this morning, who knew, but it started to dry up and it needs to be changeable because I've got seven sisters to be introduced to, the famous Beachy Head, and then Eastbourne, and the end of the South Downs Way. Soon be coming up to the sign which marks the end of the South Downs Way. Winchester to Eastbourne, 100 miles, 5 and a bit days. Gotta be happy with that. The weather,
It's been absolutely atrocious at times, can't lie to you. But I suppose that adds to the experience, kind of glorious sunshine the whole time. Oh, it has been something. It's been epic. Just like the coast to coast and now this, I'm getting quite partial to walking the length and breadth of the country. You want to give it a try. And in this 21st century world of 24/7 demands on things and ourselves, getting out for a number of days and get back in touch with not just the countryside, which is absolutely outstanding when the weather allows, but with ourselves. So for me, that'll be the end of this particular journey. I shall head off into Eastbourne, get some lunch and get an ice cream later. And then, on to the next journey. See you soon.